Just when you thought this generation couldn't get any better, and Lord knows it took some sweet time getting to the point we're at now, remember this or this? Eesh. Next year's lineup starts clicking into place. Mostly the result of many high-profile games being repeatedly delayed, take as much time as you need with Red Dead 2, Rockstar, we can at least put together a pretty clear picture of what's to come. From two incredibly risky sequels to innovative new ideas like the two-player only A Way Out or the almost certainly set to disappoint Shenmue 3, 2018 should have just as many big takeaways as this year, if not more. For now though, let's take stock of all the biggest games you can expect to play across 2018. I'm Scott from Occulture.com, and these are the 12 most anticipated video games of 2018, ranked. Number 12, Days Gone. Now the only thing stopping Days Gone from getting roasted to a crisp is its developer, Sony Bend. Responsible for creating Siphon Filter and going on to release one of the best Uncharted that wasn't made by Naughty Dog, the ASPS Vita-only Golden Abyss, Days Gone is pioneering some admittedly cool-looking zombie crowd tech. Based around pushing the PS4's hardware to the limit when it comes to rendering multiple bodies at once, Days Gone zombie hordes literally pour out of doorways and crevices to get at you. There's a World War Z-esque look to the action, and Sony Bend have incorporated a fairly grounded The Last of Us style tone for the various story sections and world-building in general. Still in danger of being generic zombie shooter number 7,615, here's hoping there's a little bit more to this come release. Number 11, Anthem. Codenamed Dylan for years, Anthem is the game that BioWare and EA redirected all of their efforts and cash into bringing to life at the expense of killing Mass Effect. Whether it will all pay off and whether this is the next Mass Effect, we'll have to wait and see. But the answer's no. Still, from what BioWare have shown off, we know Anthem is going heavy on group cooperation, letting you pick all sorts of loadouts for your Javelin exosuit before leaping into battle in a very Horizon Zero Dawn-esque world. Flight suits, groups of seeking missiles, underwater exploration, there's a chance that this could be the best playing game BioWare have ever put their name to, you just kinda have to hope that they're backing all that brawn with at least some brains. Number 10, Detroit Become Human. It will take a miracle for someone with the leaden script hand of David Cage to turn in a game about slavery, human rights, and equality without making it unbelievably cringy. We're talking about a guy who thought the best way to represent the advancement and potential fear of technology was to have you fight a living embodiment of the internet in Indigo Prophecy. A guy who did rein everything in for the mostly spectacular heavy rain, minus the voice acting,
Jason!
But who then had you battling a giant wall of sand with a face in Beyond Two Souls. Detroit Become Human is the latest from Cage's brilliant mind, and don't get me wrong, we need more of him than another Activision or another Warner Brothers, but when this looks to be yet another narrative-heavy experience with plenty of opportunities to go sideways, I'm just hoping it comes together. Number 9, Far Cry 5. Possibly delayed into 2018 to get away from the relentlessly turbulent state of American politics, Far Cry 5's hype has notably dipped, as it's most likely going to hit a little too close to home for some. Framed as a chunk of Bible Belt America being cordoned off by the doomsday cult Eden's Gate, you need only look at the gargantuan space between left and right ideologies in the West to see how various hyper-leftists would view the majority of the right as the sorts of villains in this game. Now, Ubisoft do insist that there'll be copious amounts of forestation to get lost in and animals to hunt down despite the more urban look, but the biggest question hanging over Far Cry 5's head is just how politicized its script and tonality will feel. Number 8, A Way Out. The next title from the Brothers A Tale of Two Sons team, A Way Out is taking a huge risk in 2018, as it will literally only be playable in split screen. You're free to buddy up with a randomer online, but clearly the developers want you to grab your best friend or partner, perhaps both, and embark on this awesome prison break story together. From what we've seen, it looks like mechanics include distractions and being able to interrupt each other's ongoing cutscenes, leading to full-on firefights and driving sequences once you've escaped. Dibs on the game's climax being that both players have to end up killing each other, just like in Splinter Cell Conviction. Number 7, Kingdom Hearts 3. Despite the last numbered Kingdom Hearts game releasing way back in 2005, suffice it to say, it's high time we got a proper all-new entry in the iconic franchise. Thankfully, Sora and friends are finally getting a ton of new mechanics and abilities, ranging from increased party sizes to destructible environments, new ways to fly and transition between worlds. Oh, and both Big Hero 6 and Toy Story's worlds are included too. Perfect. Number 6, Shenmue 3. Raising an unprecedented $6.3 million on Kickstarter, developers YSNet appear to have blown that cash on, background detail? The game's first trailer was a laughingstock, seeing main man Ryu literally holding the same face for its entirety, as all supplementary animations also fell short. Now there's every possibility that the only way to do another Shenmue is to make it look like what would have dropped back at the end of 2000, but man if it didn't throw a spanner in the works of all that positive buzz. Still, the fabled entry into one of gaming's most beloved franchises, interest and hype are only going to get bigger from here on out. Number 5, God of War. In something of a risky move, the new God of War looks like Dark Souls meets The Last of Us, rather than the same hack and slash template we've come to know and love. Granted, part of the series' problem was that each sequel played the exact same, but the jury's out as to whether throwing the camera behind Kratos and putting emphasis on group enemy management is actually the solution. There's also Kratos' overly chirpy son to take care of too, and despite him coming across in the earlier trailers as a damaged youngster who you'd mentor across the game, he was last heard yelling to an enemy during the Paris Games Week footage. That's not the best take for a God of War game to take, to be honest. Still, if Sony are making Naughty Dog's overshoulder narration style part of their core first-party identity, this will sit alongside The Last of Us 2 and Days Gone quite nicely. Number 4, Marvel's Spider-Man. Guaranteed to build in excitement the more we close in on launch, right now there's a strange lack of hype surrounding Insomniac's Spider-Man spin-off. Call it the been there, done that inclusion of QuickTime events and cutscenes or the baseline Batman Arkham combat, but at least all the swinging sections are more than reminiscent of Spider-Man's second movie tie-in from 2004. Now, Insomniac have stated that this plainly named Spider-Man is his own standalone story, essentially aiming to do for the Warcrawler what Rocksteady did for Batman. We've got Miles Morales, we've got the Shocker, and we've got a cool new suit. Here's hoping that it all just works. Number 3. Metroid Prime 4. Now, there's nothing but a title screen here, but just mentioning the words Metroid Prime was more than enough to whip the Nintendo populace into a stupor. The first-person shooter rework of a formerly 2D side-scroller, the Prime series helped make the GameCube one of the most beloved consoles of all time. With subsequent sequels, though, Metroid would lean heavily into motion controls, even re-releasing the original trilogy with them bolted on. Going forward, one of the biggest questions surrounding Prime 4 is whether or not it'll actually rely on the same waggling and gyroscope-style aiming, despite the Switch-based need to take the game on the go. Here's hoping it won't, and we'll get a Metroid Prime that is all about the gameplay, perhaps even perfecting the hybrid side-scrolling, shooting, and combat combo from Other M. Number 2, The Last of Us 2. Like many, I balked at the idea of A Last of Us 2, but time and again, Naughty Dog have pulled a phenomenal script out of nowhere, justifying these otherwise unnecessary sequels against all odds. First, it was Uncharted 4, which reframed Drake as a retired adventurer longing for the high of treasure hunting, and then Uncharted Lost Legacy, which for my money is the second best Uncharted of them all. Come on, nothing beats 2. Now, with The Last of Us 2, we don't know much outside of Ellie harboring a grudge against the Fireflies and that there's a new character in the midst, although you can check out our fan theories video to see some potential plot threads that we hope come true. Number 1, Red Dead Redemption 2. Simply put, nobody has the surplus cash on hand like Rockstar. They make around $5 million a day from GTA Online, and they'll surely put just as much money into bringing the Wild West to life like nothing else. So far, that's meant stunning vistas that almost connote Alejandro Iñárritu's The Revenant, a group story detailing John Marsden's life as part of Dutch's gang, potentially multiple playable characters, and all sorts of nefarious ways to make money and survive. There's also the small matter of Rockstar registering Red Dead Online as a website too, which if that happens to take off like GTA Online did, it'll see us all donning Stetsons and twin pistols before next Christmas. And that's our list. Which games are you most looking forward to in 2018? Sound off in the comments, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I've been Scott from OurCulture.com, and I'll see you soon.